Hello there, and welcome to Mr. Tom Teaches Again. My name is Mr. Tom. If you think back to the last time we met, we were just finished going over how to subtract two-digit numbers using a hundreds chart. Now, it's time for us to start getting ready to remember our addition and subtraction facts. Then we can do the simple addition and subtraction in our heads. A really good way to learn to do this is to learn fact families. Today, we'll look at what a fact family is, how fact family triangles work, and see a simple fact family and how its number sentences look. But before we start, if you find the video helpful, please be sure to like and subscribe. And if you think it could help someone else, feel free to share. And now, let's look into what fact families are all about. I'd like you to meet Super Math Person. Super Math Person looks for super ways for all of us to understand math. Recently, he was flying around and heard someone say, "Fact family." He turned his head to see who was talking and almost crashed into a building.
Oh no!
So, Super Math Person landed and asked himself, "What is a fact family?" He did a little research and found out that a fact family is a set of three numbers that are related. Related means they go together for some reason. One type of fact family can make addition and subtraction facts. Using his super math senses, he discovered an example. 5, 3, and 2. 5, 3, and 2, he thought. Well, I know 3 plus 2 equals 5. Hey! And 2 plus 3 equals 5. I got 2 addition facts out of that.
Wow!
Super Math Person then wondered, can I get subtraction facts out of this fact family too? He decided to start with the 5. Whoa. 5 minus 3 equals 2. And 5 minus 2 equals 3. He got 4 facts out of those related numbers. But is there something that people can see that can help them figure the facts out, he wondered? Super Math Person thought really hard and realized that there sure is a fact family triangle. Super Math Person drew a triangle. Then he took the largest number and put it in the top, and the other two numbers and put them on the bottom. Super Math Person then realized, if you start at the bottom, go over and up, you can come up with addition facts. And if you start at the top and go down and over, you come up with subtraction facts. Let's try another fact family and see what we come up with, he thought. The next family was 1, 1, and 0. He plugged in the numbers like this. The largest number will go to the top. Since there are 2 ones, one of them goes to the top. The other 2 numbers went to the bottom. And then he tried working with the numbers to make addition and subtraction facts. Start at the bottom, go over and up, he thought. 1 plus 0 equals 1. And 0 plus 1 equals 1. Cool. And now let's try subtraction, he said. Start at the top, go down and over. 1 minus 1 equals 0. And 1 minus 0 equals 1. Awesome! Super Math Person understood how fact families work and how fact family triangles can help us get addition and subtraction facts. So, let's review what Super Math Person discovered. First, a group of related numbers that can make addition and subtraction sentences is called a fact family. One example of a fact family includes the numbers 5, 3, and 2. Super Math Person got 4 number sentences out of these 3 numbers. 3 plus 2 equals 5. 2 plus 3 equals 5. 5 minus 3 equals 2. And 5 minus 2 equals 3. And if we need to see something to figure out the number sentences, a fact family triangle is a perfect tool. He tried another fact family. 1, 1, and 0. He set up the fact family triangle like this. And he was able to find 4 number sentences. 1 plus 0 equals 1. 0 plus 1 equals 1. 1 minus 1 equals 0. And 1 minus 0 equals 1. Super math person thought to himself, I can now tell the world what I know about fact families and fact family triangles. Well, there you have it. Fact families can help us find addition and subtraction facts, and fact family triangles help us see how these fact family numbers are related. If you found the video helpful, please be sure and give it a like. If you'd like to see more, please subscribe. And if you think someone else might find it useful, please share. Come back next time when we look at fact families for 2 and 3. I'll see you next time. And remember, it never hurts to be nice.